In this video, we will do a side-by-side diamond pendant size comparison of a necklace or chain, as well as give you different price comparisons at each size, all along giving you different tips and tricks to help you save on diamond shopping. We will compare all the diamond sizes in this video to this 1-carat diamond on a necklace on a model that is 5'7" tall. This 1-carat diamond at Kay Jewelers, like most brick and mortar jewelry stores, is about $19,600. And that is because it is very high quality. In fact, all the pendant diamonds on the chest in this video are all an ideal cut and very high quality. Now, we also take those diamonds and compare them to the exact same quality diamond from a link I will put in the description below this video. This 1-carat is $9,150, so you'd save over $10,000 from the link below this video on this high quality 1-carat diamond. Let's start with a 0.25 or 1/4-carat diamond on the neck chain. Compared to a 1-carat diamond, it is very unimpressive, and normally people don't go this low for a pendant diamond. Its main appeal though is it's only $580 from the link I have below this video. Next, we look at a 0.33 or 1/3-carat necklace diamond. Usually this is the lowest people go for a necklace diamond. Carat is actually just the weight of the diamond. So remember, just because it is a higher carat doesn't necessarily mean it is visually bigger. A 0.4-carat diamond is starting to look a little more substantial than the others. Something to look out for, you can actually increase the carat size of the stone without it looking bigger. However, since these diamonds are ideally cut, you can be sure this is not the case. Watch more of my diamond videos for more on this. A 0.5-carat or 1/2-carat diamond is a more common size of a diamond. If you would have bought this diamond at Jared, you would have paid $1,000 more than from my recommended online website I have below this video. First four diamonds we looked at compared to each other, you can see a gradual increase in the size. To make sure you get a good diamond that looks its carat size, check the GIA diamond certificate for an excellent or ideal cut. Once again, I can't say that enough. And you want to check that before buying a diamond in a store, otherwise a diamond store will have the diamond cut so that it doesn't look as big as the carat suggests it should. Watch my other diamond videos if you want more information on that. This is a 0.66 or 2/3-carat diamond. While it is getting closer to a 1-carat, it still looks a bit smaller. Online, you'd save over $4,000 on an ideal diamond this size. A 0.7 or 3/4-carat diamond is starting to get close to a 1-carat diamond, as you can see. Kay Jewelers has this diamond at $10,400, but only $3,900 from the link you can find below the video. This is a 0.85-carat diamond. Another way diamond stores trick you is by advertising the total carat weight of a pendant or a ring as opposed to just the center stone carat weight. If this pendant had little diamonds all around it, they could say that it's 1.5-carat TW or total weight and hope you didn't know the difference. Watch my other videos to understand how jewelry stores trick you into buying poor quality diamonds for a lot more, because this is one of the tricks you'll find there. 0.95-carat diamonds and above are interesting diamonds. Most people like buying slightly below 1 carat because the difference in size is so minute, but the cost jumps a lot as soon as you hit the 1 carat mark. Plus, most people still just call it a 1-carat diamond because it's so close. So you're just getting the best of both worlds in my opinion. I really recommend sticking slightly below 1 carat unless you are looking to go way above 1 carat. And once again, all these diamonds have an ideal cut. If they didn't, the jewelers would play with the angles and the cut of the diamonds to make the carat weight go up without the appearance of it going up, and you'd get less sparkle and more cost. Here is a 1.25 or a 1 1/4-carat pendant diamond on the necklace. On this, you'd save $17,000 buying it from the link below this video if it had all the same specs. This is a 1 1/2 or 1.5-carat diamond comparison. And in my opinion, on the neck, this is where you start to look like a high roller. This diamond is close to a $20,000 savings if you get it from the link below this video. This is a 2-carat diamond on the finger. I decided to show you the price for this diamond at the Helzberg Diamond Store, which is over $84,000. I just want to show you that it doesn't matter which of all these brick and mortar jewelry stores you go to, they all are overpriced in my opinion. So my number one tip to buying a pendant diamond is to have your significant other go diamond shopping at the mall with you or her best friend or whoever, and set a budget on the diamond, and then make sure you stay above an H color and a VS2 clarity. I never compromise on the cut of a diamond, as that is a compromise on the sparkle of the diamond and possibly on how big the diamond looks. Then with the rest of your budget and those specs, spend the rest on the biggest carat possible. I have tons of tips on diamond buying, so watch one of my videos at the end of this video to know more on how to get better deals. Just for your info, I have tons of videos on diamonds and how to save money on them and how to not get ripped off. If you decide to buy a diamond, make sure you come back to this video and click on that link. Or even if you switch to another device, come back to this video and click on that link, because it will help you out. And just a shout out to the model in this video. She has a YouTube channel that does live daily hair and makeup tutorials. People love that channel. I will put her channel up right now. So like, subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.